impact. I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella bella, le busque todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino camp.
Yeah, I can't get enough of your love. Give me some more of it. I can't get enough.
Come on.
Yeah. 'Cause I can't get crazy.
In the playground, teases the opponent with a sequence of dance moves and still gets the block. One of the more disrespectful plays I've ever seen. I don't want to leave the playground, so let's move on with Dream Killer Bez. After a failed alley-oop lob, teammate flies in for the successful poster dunk. You know what they say.
We're the land.
Of enthusiasm around that presentation of the Star Spangled Banner. And we've got plenty more coming up. Stay tuned. We welcome you to Noche NBA here on 2K Sports. From the attire to the food, the players' jerseys, tonight a celebration of the Latin culture. In this game, we'll see the Detroit Pistons going up against the Miami Heat here at the American Airlines Arena. This is Kevin Harlan, and by my side, Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. From the sideline, Hall of Famer David Aldridge. And a look here at the scoring trend over the last several months for him.
And it's really been a nice trend for him over these last several months. He's been steadily improving in terms of his scoring output. That extra production making him more valuable the further we get along in this season.
Now let's send it down to David Aldridge, standing by from the sidelines. David?
Well, guys, for all of the star power Blake Griffin had when he was in Los Angeles, it was tough for him to be the leader of the Clippers. There were bigger voices in the locker room, such as CP3 and Doc Rivers. But Pistons coach Dwayne Casey said, in Detroit, he's definitely the leader. When he speaks, everybody listens. This is his team. Kevin?
Yeah, and he has their confidence. David, thank you. And tonight, two experienced teams, Chris, we're going to see. What's something you learned as a veteran that you wish you had known as you were just entering the NBA?
It's one thing that you could not have learned, and that's pacing.
how to pace yourself during the game. As a rookie, you're playing, coming from college, and the game is so slow in college. And when you come to the NBA, you figure, wait a minute, this 24-second shot clock, oh, that's not much. But you realize after about four times up and down the court, wait a minute, how do I figure this out? How do I switch right. gears? How do I lock in and play defense and then run my butt off to the other end as fast as I can to get an easy layup? And a lot of those things, it's not about being in shape, but the mentality and understanding how to take advantage of the next play.
Yeah, I like that. And a look at the starters for the Pistons. At the forward positions, Snell and Griffin. Kennard is out there with Derrick Rose. And it's Wood in at the five. And for Miami, they've got Robinson. Jones is out there with Adebayo. Then there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Nunn in at the point. And with this summer's signing of Jimmy Butler, the Miami Heat demonstrating they still can lure star talent to South Beach.
The Heat back on the rise. The Butler signing sets the stage for the summer of 2021 when they should have the cap space to sign another max player.
Played in with a nice touch off the glass.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you had to bring much faster help than that.
Here's Kennard to the paint. Here's Rose. And the layup's good off the glass.
And as long as he retains that great explosion in his legs, Derrick Rose will be a factor around the rim.
Here's Nunn. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
Okay, listen, you got to body him up when he's in the paint. If you play off of him, then that's just two easy points.
Here's Rose, right through the D for the layup.
And how about the airtime improvisation from Derrick Rose, able to hang and finish with a defender looming.
It's deflected. Here's Kennard. He's been a factor in their offense on most nights with his scoring average at nearly 16 points a game.
Boy, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
Yeah, that's because he's getting his number called early. I mean, he's doing his part to help carry the offensive load.
Detroit's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. And misses it off the right side of the rim.
Jesus surprises anyone with that miss. When he's left alone like that, you can usually count it. Nothing less than that kind of defense will cut it against him. That's just great work inside.
To the left wing. Here's Snell, guarded by Robinson. High post shot, and he hits the jump shot. And that's now 9 points for Derrick Rose.
And he's caught fire this quarter, yet to miss a shot.
Here's Nunn. Offensive struggles continue, missing again. Here's Kennard, and he drops in the layup off the glass.
Oh, great ball movement there.
The Heat have gone 3-7 from the field since we've gotten underway. Robinson drives in, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the foul against Detroit. This is his first trip to the line tonight.
Two.
First free throw is good.
And a coach that players love is Dwayne Casey. Very vet friendly, sticks up for his guys in every post-game interview.
Casey is very measured in his approach. He can be a bit slow to change at times, but his players appreciate the consistency.
He hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line. Detroit leading by 3. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes played, Kennard, another 3 for Detroit.
And they don't want to get in a habit of giving him open looks from 3. First quarter still, but not who you want to leave open.
Count it. Jones Jr. And it's Rose with the ball for the Detroit Pistons, coming off that loss against Philadelphia. And the slam by Blake Griffin.
And that was the play to make. Rose making the right read.
For Miami, they've gone 50% from the field to this point, 4 of 8. Here's Butler. Rebound by the Pistons. Inside. The shot's good from Kennard. Kennard's got 7 points in the game.
Derrick Rose.
Well, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. They keep getting it in the paint and continue to score consistently.
He's sneaky good from deep sometimes. I mean, when he gets clean looks, he's got the ability to do some damage out there.
Here is Rose. The Heat knocking down the tray. Another 3 for Detroit.
He's putting the hammer down. Dominant quarter for him, trying to push out that lead.
Butler passes to Jones. The shot's good on the assist by Butler. He has 7.
Well, I think Jimmy Buckets has underrated vision. He's more than capable of spotting open teammates and distributing accordingly.
And that's out of bounds. Detroit will retain possession. Scanning the floor. Count that bucket.
It's no wonder why they're in front when you take into consideration that he's been perfect from the field so far.
Here's Nunn. That one a tad offline to the right, but drops in for him.
Shots are just flowing for him right now, having a really strong quarter.
Here's Rose. Lead pass was put in just the right spot.
His energy level has never dropped in his game. I mean, he's working his tail off. And the D struggling to keep up.
Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, GA. He really does put pressure on you.
And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
Launches a 3. And Jones pulls it down. The Heat trail by 6. Butler goes in.
Oh, the power on that booty!
Wow, Butler letting it all hang out. This is why he's an all-star caliber player.
Passes it to Snell. Lets it go from deep. It's good from long range.
They've wasted no time settling into their offense.
Here's Nunn. He's covered by Rhodes. Nunn, that's good. Nunn's got 13.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Rose passes to Griffin. It's good.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Here's Nunn. It falls for his 7th bucket of the contest. He's 7 for 9.
And he's clearly led the way offensively. The question is, can they ride him and get back into it?
Rose, good once again. That makes him 8 for 9 this game.
And that's the Derrick Rose of old. Full speed ahead and bursting to the rim.
Here's Adebayo. Hits the front of the rim and out.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
Well, you're right. He'd take that 10 out of 10 times. He's not going to miss many of those.
Dragic.
Crowder with the steal. And even 3-on-3 break. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here. That one on Rose.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
And Bam Adebayo. He just plays with so much energy when he's on the floor.
Boy, he is ferocious on both ends of the floor. Great energy player who can finish in the paint with the best of them. Very quick on his feet and can cover a lot of ground for a player his size.
Throw good, Adebayo. Just when it comes to offensive rebounding, who does the best job of creating second chance opportunities now?
Oh, it's 2 names. Andre Drummond, it's
Steven Adams. And the toughest part about it is, as a defender, you don't only have to worry about guarding your man, going over and helping, but then you have to worry about guys that are just hanging out in the rebound painted area, just waiting for their turn. And so it takes the wind out of you, it tires you out, but also your mental focus that game is all over the place, because no matter what you're doing, you always have to come back to the thought, oh no, now box out, because this guy's a beast on the boards.
The D just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
Oh, Kevin, the coaching staff has to be upset. You can't give the opposition easy buckets like this, GA.
There's Galloway after the made shot from Goran Dragic. Knocked loose. It's stolen by Dragic. In transition, here comes Miami. And Butler gets it to go. Now just a three-point Piston lead.
Aggressive pass on the break straight up the court so he can get all the way to the bucket.
There's Galloway. He's guarded by Dragic. Pass to Snell. Jacks up a three. That's good. And so Galloway with the assist. Snell's got six.
Outstanding start from three-point range. Their shooters are on fire.
Here's Hero. And another basket for Miami.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
Galloway taking his time here. Pass to Griffin. Here's Kennard. Off the mark there with the three-point shot.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
His second shot goes in, off to a good start, two for two.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
The Pistons leading. Up top, Griffin. Kennard, the pass to Griffin. Back to Kennard. Pistons passing it around. Galloway. Rebound by Butler.
Oh, you expect him to make those. They've got to do more to get a hand in his face next time.
The game now all time.
From that in-between range, they've been the much better team.
There's Galloway. He's guarded by Dragic. Here's Wood. Miami grabs the miss. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them. Here's Adebayo. Yes, that goes in. And the Heat lead by two.
Punch, counter punch. Impressive offensive production early on.
Yeah, and this is what you love to see. Both teams going at it, working to get to their spots and cashing in.
And they keep hammering away at them inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Banked in off the glass. Hero's got his third basket of the night. And it's Galloway with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Pistons. And there's the pass to Wood. To the inside. Shot's good by Kennard.
Oh, forget about three-pointers. Give me a look from right in tight. I'll take it all day long.
And it's Miami's ball. Here's Dragic. And another basket for Miami.
And that's definitely a shot that he has in his arsenal.
Dragic has gone a perfect 3-for-3 so far. Knocks it loose. All alone. Finishes the break with a slam.
Great awareness being shown by Crowder. Spotted the open man and made a fantastic dish.
Pistons trail by four. And the Pistons decide to take their first timeout right here. The Heat beat them last time when these two teams met down in South Florida.
Yeah, and looking back at their last game against this club, they were badly out-rebounded.
some changes. Olenek is checked in for Bam Adebayo. Leonard comes in for Butler. And it's Iguodala in for Hero. Crowd wide open. He fires. Again, the miss by the Pistons.
Come on. You got to get up on him and play some defense. They won't get away with that next time.
Oh, inflicting some punishment with the two-hand flush.
They're going for the throat. Pistons trail by six. There's 1:38 left in the first quarter.
Oh, great flow to that possession. Two players totally in sync with each other.
Leonard, that's for two. And out of bounds, the Pistons will take it.
You look back at the Blake Griffin trade. Many thought the Pistons gave up too much, but it's worked out for them.
Yeah, losing the picks for Griffin, you have to admit, it did hurt. But people forget that Griffin is a star player, and he reminded those same people last year. He's become the leader for this franchise as they try to move forward.
Now Leonard, after Sekou Doumbouya misses from long range.
That's his first personal foul.
.112 left in the first quarter. Here's Leonard. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. And the Heat lead by six.
And I like the decision making. He's taking what the defense is willing to give him.
Oh, yeah. And that's just a good read on his part. And as usual, his mid-range jumper is on point.
Crowder goes in, and the shot is good. And now an 8-point Miami lead.
And you can see just how much effort Crowder has put into improving the mid-range J.
Here's McCray. Hits the three-point bomb.
But the D didn't do a good enough job on him. He could be an ace when he gets a good look at three.
Inside, here's Leonard. Oh, and the jam by Leonard.
Yeah, I mean, maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that one.
And we know he's capable of those memorable ones. Here's McCray. His last outing, he had 8 points. And it's Doumbouya in the corner. And it's off from three-point range. The Heat leading by seven. Crowder goes in. Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
Taking the initiative. Crowder going in strong.
Now, here's Doumbouya. Two on the clock. The shot, no good. And so it's Miami in control with a 9-point lead to end the quarter. A terrific tempo and a great pace. The fast break has been a central part of their offense. And we'll be right back after this. Tough Nose Jimmy Butler talks about the mantle of being a franchise player.
Call me a leader, all-star, whatever you want to call it. But with that comes a lot of, you know, some people call it pressure, but a lot of responsibility is what I call it. You know, every night you got to show up. You have to be productive. You have to show guys even when you're hurt, you can still play. Even when you're tired, you got to go out there and do what you're supposed to do. It's fun to me. I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way.
And that's what he worked for. And he works as hard as anyone, Greg, in the NBA.
And you see that competitiveness and desire in his play.
Welcome back, everyone, to the second quarter of play here on Noche Latina. Vámonos. And let's quickly break down the game we've seen from Miami, guys.
Impressive start. They came in with a well-conceived game plan and have executed.
Well, yeah, this is their preferred pace, and it's gotten them out to an early lead.
Iguodala out there with Dragic. Then there's Myers Leonard. Then it's Kelly Olynyk, and it's Silva in at the small forward. So that's who Miami starts the second with. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, Jimmy Butler has made several All-Star teams, but he remains single-minded in pursuit of his bigger goal. Butler said, "I just want to win a championship. That's all that matters. I didn't do it in high school, didn't do it in college. If I don't win it here, then I'll go to the 50 and over league someday. But I gotta win a championship at some stage. Kevin?
I like that attitude. Thank you, D.A.
He is a fantastic athlete for a power forward. Whatever he lacks in height, he makes up for with hops.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Here's McCray. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. And so it's going to be a 3-second violation out there on the defense.
Foul has been called on the Heat.
And the veteran Goran Dragic still producing late in his career. Not the force he once was, but always a source of playmaking and scoring.
You look at the career of Dragic, Greg, he's always been a scoring point guard.
Yeah, and as Dragic has aged, he has learned to lean more and more on his outside shot. Even when his first step and speed start to falter, he'll find ways to put up points.
The Pistons making a change here. Moses checked in. Pass to Brown. He feeds it to Maker. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
This is the touch Maker possesses. A big man who knows he can sink these shots.
Dragic with it. And Dumboya picks him up defensively. He gets that one.
Dragic!
And it's Rose with the ball for the Pistons. When this game is done, they'll be off to take on the Raptors. That's game 4 of 4 out on the road for them.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's +5 in that category.
And there it is for them. And it's a 9-point Miami lead. For Detroit, they've gone 3 of their first 5 shots to drop here in the second quarter. Leonard brings the double team. It's picked off. And a little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second quarter. That one goes. Count it. And the Heat lead by 11.
Not a lot of resistance on the inside, and they're taking full advantage.
Pass to Dumboya. Here's Mykhailiuk. Buries it down low. Mykhailiuk's got 5 points so far.
Dumboya.
The pass to Silva from the baseline, and he knocks down the jumper.
I mean, it took him a long time to get into the flow of the game, but the points are starting to come for him now.
Pass to Mykhailiuk. The 3. Rebound by Olynyk. Olynyk's got his 5th rebound right now in the game. Now here's Dragic. Defense right on him. Lucky 7 drops in. He's perfect from the floor. 7 for 7.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm. And you can see how they're finishing their play.
Yeah, right now it feels like they can't miss. We'll see how long they can make this last.
Pistons have gone 1 for 1, making their previous attempt at the line. And the technical free throw is good. The creation of the super teams, Chris, is enough being done to ensure a competitive balance in the NBA.
I think so. I think that every year we're going to have to evolve in trying to do enough and see what happened the previous year. But yeah, and the fact remains, though, Kevin, is, you know, I like working with you. You're my friend. I would go work with you. And in basketball, you want to go play with your friends.
Same stuff, yeah.
How do you stop that?
Right.
I don't know. When guys get to hang out in the summer and say, wouldn't it be cool if we got to play together, our kids would play together, we could win one? That's going to be hard to deter. So I just think it's about how strong the will of the friends are. And more importantly, what is the league doing to kind of not necessarily give as much incentive to do that? But I think the league is doing a great job staying proactive, giving guys a lot of incentive, a lot of reason, a lot of dinero to stay at home with the team.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
Well, that's what I would say about Iguodala's game. Relentless.
Passes it to Mykhailiuk. Dumboya with it. Back to Brown. Here's Mikhailuk. Rebound by the Heat. The drive by Iguodala, and that one drops for him. And the Heat lead by 16.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
Detroit's gone 7 of 15 from three-point range tonight. They're not afraid of that shot. Brown the pass to Mikhailuk. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Mikhailuk's got 7 points.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
Robinson, that's good.
Just playing with poise and confidence, and they continue to put points on the board.
Yeah, Greg, they're just playing smart basketball, reading the floor well and executing.
Here's Rose after the Heat pick up two. And it's Henson atop the key. He can't get that one. And Miami the other way now. Down low. And the jam by Andre Iguodala.
Oh, the quick jump of Iguodala. Easy money.
Pistons trail by 18. Rose passes to Dumboya. Brown outside. Pass to Rose. Shot clock at 6. Out to the right wing. Here's Mikhailuk. A three-pointer is right on target. Mikhailuk's got 8 points in the quarter.
He's been fantastic, but he can't do it all by himself. Some of the other guys need to lighten the load and step up.
Out of bounds. Detroit takes possession. Here are the top shooters from deep this month. These guys have been raining down threes lately. Kelly Olynyk on top.
Sometimes a three-point shooter gets into that rhythm and just keeps carrying it over. That's been the case for him the entire month.
And Miami calls their first timeout of the game.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
You know, that's what coaches are paid to do, right? I mean, curious to see what they go with here.
She gon' get it, I need it, my friends is itching. Vacation, I'm living, got so many Benjamins, they think I'm getting it pregnant. Hey. I came with them, did. Still living in crib, you can't even comfort a kid. Maybe to walk you just want some money. I'm in that ghost, you just set it with honey. I walk you up and I do what I want. Just spend it like 30. I got enough bread to feed you the bird. Bought up diamond dish. I'm in New York, I'm making my status. Speaking out facts.
A chance to look at Jimmy Butler. He showed up every night and some noteworthy performances over the last month. He's putting up about 17 points, 5 assists, and 5 rebounds. Fantastic totals for him across the board. I wouldn't be surprised if he keeps rolling.
I think if you talk to anyone on this team, they believe in his abilities 100%.
And then Griffin with the dunk.
A main staple of Griffin's game. You can tell he loves getting up to dunk.
Here's Nunn, and they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
Nunn.
And Chris, just how special was it to play for Detroit in your career? What relationship does this team have with their fans?
Yeah, it was so special. I mean, being able to go home to the house that I grew up in or to where my parents lived and be able to go to the Pistons practice and to be part of it, to put on that jersey. It was so special, man. This team is a mainstay of the city. I mean, you feel like you can lift up the whole city when you play for the Pistons. It was such a special part of my career.
Players have different ways of leading. Some guys, Chris, are loud and fiery. Others let their play do all the talking. What was your approach?
Well, Kevin, it depended on what situation I was in. When I was in Sacramento, Derrick I could Rose. Be the quiet, fiery guy that led through my actions because Vlade was more of a vocal guy, and we had a really good spirited team, so I didn't need to do much besides what we did in practice. In my younger days, when you want to win, you want to get out there, and maybe everyone doesn't have the sense of urgency that you do. You're a little bit more vocal, but I've always believed that the best leaders, no matter how well they communicate or anything else, the best leaders lead by example. And if you're telling everyone what to do and you're not doing it, usually it falls on deaf ears. So go out there and do it by example first, and everybody will follow.
Good advice. Here's Hero. And Henson sends it back. Hands the ball out of bounds. Henson touched it last. Pulls from the top of the key. Jump shot is good that time. Adebayo's got six. And so it's Rose who brings the ball up for the Pistons. And stolen by Butler. Here's Hero. And he gets it to go, hitting off the back of the rim. He's got eight.
Oh, Butler, he's a jack of all trades. He doesn't just look to score. He's also happy to distribute as well.
Galloway, no good.
And they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the tip. Their rebounding edge right now, massive.
Here's Rose, and he finishes nicely on the layup. Rose has got 27 points.
And when Rose gets going and gets this kind of confidence offensively, you're in trouble. He can just flat out take over again. Man, he sure can get off the floor.
He's one of the best in the business, absolutely. Pistons trailed by 16. Oh, Griffin in position, and the slam by Blake Griffin.
Look, a big man with major ups. I mean, Griffin wants to use his athleticism as much as possible.
None.
Tender.
And it's Miami with another.
And nice job taking what the defenders gave him. These guys need a gut check right now.
I mean, I don't know what they were thinking. You have to know the scouting report. He's a threat from out there.
This is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
Yeah, because it's so hard to prevent transition scores. Whenever you get an opportunity to get out and run, you take it.
Yep, that one goes in there. Nunn's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Yeah, right now it feels like they can't miss. We'll see how long they can make this last.
Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. Here's Butler, and slam dunk by Butler.
Flashing that leaping ability there. Butler really gets off the floor fast when he's near the hoop.
Detroit's gotten cold from deep in the second quarter, just 2-6 from long range. Rose kicks to Kennard. Took the opportunity when he saw it. Kennard's got 11.
Assisted.
Here's Nutt. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against Charlotte. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
And usually teams go on runs, and it comes from a lot of layups and dunks. But not now.
The pass to Henson. Pistons passing it around. Kennard. Rebound by the Heat. Adebayo's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Leaner from distance.
2 minutes.
Here's Jones. Griffin with some nice D.
The D making that layup look very uncomfortable for him. Good aggressive work down low.
Galloway, the pass to Griffin. It's blocked. They retain possession. 1:37 left in the first half. Sinks the triple. He's got 12. Here's Rose. He's got 27. Some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, right now you just need a bucket to get some momentum.
A flawless finish on the alley-oop.
Oh, what a pass. And then he lays it in with the circus move.
So smooth. And Adebayo throws it down.
Such incredible hops for a center. Look, it allows him to hold his own against any other 5 in the league.
Rose kicks to Henson. It's Adebayo with the rebound. Adebayo's got his seventh rebound here tonight. Nice 4-for-7 from the floor with that shot. Here is Rose. A good portion of the scoring has come from him. He averages more than 18 points a game. Pass to Kennard. And here is Henson, defended by Butler. And Griffin scores. The assist by Henson. And 12 points for Blake Griffin.
There isn't a defender in the league who wants to take on Griffin inside. I mean, he's going to take you to school down there.
The offensive rebound. Adebayo with the bucket.
And defensively, guys, they've been unable to shut down the middle.
Detroit's gotten gold from deep in the second quarter, just 2-of-6 from long range. Now Griffin, 12 points for him. Henson's shot is off. 4 seconds left. Nice jump shot. Good. Adebayo's got 14 points. And so it's Miami, having no problems at all. Up 29 points heading into the next quarter. They've got a big advantage in the turnover stats because of their intense defense. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks. Here with Jimmy Butler. Jimmy, you have come a long way in this league. When you look at your career now versus when you came in, how different is it?
Much different. I think on the floor, I'm supposed to do a lot more on both ends of the floor. And off the floor, I think it's still the same. People recognize my hair.
Well, it is a unique style. Jimmy, thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello, basketball fans. What a pleasure it is to bring you into the 2K studios again. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. So it's Miami who's out on top at the half. They are completely in control of the game, leading by a massive amount. Kenny, what do you think?
Well, they built this lead in large part because of the sharpshooters off the bench. The subs played a superb game. Get it? Sub, superb. Oh, I'm rolling tonight. I mean, they played like starters.
Check, what'd you think about the Pistons?
Well, they got a ton of issues to work out. Allow a way too high a percentage to be shot against them. Not really showing any energy on defense. No discipline. Look at their faces, Ernie. Do they even want to be here?
And that'll about do it as we get ready for the second half. Let's take it down to Kevin Harlan.
Shout out to my man, Joel.
Joel, what up?
Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. A fantastic game from Derrick Rose in this one.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
Yeah, the offense looks crisp, and guys are hitting their shots.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. And, well, Detroit, shooting has been beyond great up until now. How about 57% from the field overall? Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. On the court for the Pistons, on the wings, Kennard and Snell.
Jimmy
Wood out there with Griffin, and it's Rose in at the point guard position. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, in Blake Griffin, the Pistons have their biggest star in years, probably going back to their championship team of 2004. A return to all-star form for Blake meant tremendous individual numbers last season.
Kendrick!
Pistons hadn't won a playoff game in more than a decade. Still not the result they want in 2019. The Pistons will be trying to capitalize during Blake's prime. Kevin, we'll see where this franchise goes from here.
We sure will, David, but he's a terrific player. Thank you so much.
Even for a player who's not a three-point specialist, I mean, that's a shot you've got to knock down.
None, that's good.
pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
And one of the hardest working players you'll find, Jimmy Butler. At the same time, you know what, Chris? He's not afraid to challenge his teammates.
Yeah, within his team, he's a culture setter, Kevin. I mean, I think he's learning that balance of being vocal, but also knowing that just how far he can push his teammates.
And the Heat call time here.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Yeah, I like the chess match that's going on here. Each team trying to find and exploit the favorable matchup on the floor.
To look at numbers for Snell, how the second half of the season has shaped up for him, averaging about 7 points, 3 assists, and 2 rebounds. Nothing about his numbers really jump out at you, but he'll come up with a timely play or two every game.
Yeah, and sometimes that's all they need, especially in tight games. One or two plays can make all the difference.
Robinson finds Adebayo. Good, and the assist goes to Robinson. Robinson's got his third assist on the night.
It hasn't taken them any time to find their rhythm in the second half. 4 for 4 from the field already.
Now here's Rose. 27 points for him. Robinson with the block. Here's Butler. And slam dunk by Butler.
You gotta love his aggressiveness to finish inside.
Well, his leaping ability gives him a great advantage. Here is Rose. In the corner, Snell with it. To the paint, here's Wood. Good, nice job down low.
Assisted.
Wood's got 8 points.
Oh, that's a well-deserved assist. Not every player has the vision to make that feed.
None. Off the left rim and out. The Pistons have gone 4-6 from the field since the start of the third. And that's out of bounds. Detroit will retain possession.
Detroit ball.
The Heat making a switch here.
Dragic. Jay Crowder.
A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. The kick out to Rose. Free throw line jump shot. Crowder pulls it in. The Heat have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second half. Tremendous efficiency. Here's Adebayo. Rebounded by the Pistons. Woods got 4 rebounds in this game. Snell from outside. And again, it's the Pistons missing. Heat shooting an almost unfair 78% from the field. And the shot goes in. 14 points for him.
Getting out on the break. Butler completes the transition play.
Over to the wing. Here's Snell. It's good. This time the assist from Rose. And it's Dragic bringing up the ball for Miami. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. And that'll be the third of the 4 straight at home.
Oh, from role player to star, Butler's transformation has been fun to watch. Now he racks up points with ease.
Here's Griffin, and 2 free throws coming up, unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Well, Kev, you know I always appreciate when a big man can create for others. Blake Griffin, he's one of the best in the game in that regard. Such a fantastic passer.
Free throw drops for Griffin. Chris, you almost forget just how big Griffin is because of how smoothly he can facilitate for others.
Yeah, Kevin, and I hate when people say he's a good passer for a big man. I mean, what type of caveat is that? He's just a good passer. He has great vision, superb timing, and that's why he's always been near the top in assists for bigs.
That one is no good.
I love watching Griffin play the game. I mean, he has a lot of confidence in his abilities. He's terrific at staying aggressive.
Here's Iguodala. A tad short, but it's good off the front iron. Iguodala's got 8 points. Detroit's gone into the three-point range 4 times since halftime and buried 2 of them. Griffin goes in. It's deflected. Iguodala with the steal. Here's Crowder, and that's good. Robinson picking up the assist. Robinson's got his 6th assist on the night. The Pistons have gone even 5 of 10 on shot attempts in the third. Here's McRae, guarded by Robinson. And again, it's the Pistons missing. And it's the Heat on the break. Crowder with the ball. And it's Miami with another.
And we're seeing some great ball movement out of this group, guys.
Pistons shooting 45% from the field since coming out of the locker room at halftime. In the corner, it's Griffin. With the putback, he hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points. He's got 10.
Oh, smooth. Guys, very good job getting himself in close enough that he could just tip it back in.
Well said. Those kind of plays in the offensive glass can tell the story sometimes, can't they? And so it's Detroit with the ball. After the miss from Goran Dragic.
Ooh, the one-hand tomahawk, guys. Somebody's going to get their feelings hurt.
Yeah, that they got the entire bench up right there as they saw that and out of their chair.
That's their third straight make off an assist.
For Detroit, they've gotten half their shots to drop in the second half, up to this point going 7 of 14. And the slam assist by Blake Griffin.
Bruce. The assist is the key to that sequence. I mean, a great look to set them up.
Iguodala, no good. The Pistons have gone better than 53% from the floor since halftime, shooting 8 of 15. And good that time. McRae has got 5 now.
They should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
The Heat shooting an almost unfair 78% from the field. Robinson, that one a little long.
It isn't the D that causes that miss. That's just a loss of concentration that time.
Snell from outside. Miami grabs the miss. It's Iguodala with the drive. Up and in on the layup.
And getting a quick head of steam. Iguodala beats the defense to the punch.
And, well, Detroit shooting has just been outstanding tonight. 56% as a team in this game. Here's McRae. He has 5. Too long in the paint, and he's hit with a 3-second violation.
Has been called on the Heat.
Detroit shooting their 5th attempt at the line in the game.
And 74% has been the mark for them on the season thus far.
And so he hits the technical free throw. Olenek, he's checked in for Miami. And Detroit with a change here, too. Makers checked in for Blake Griffin. To the middle. Here's McRae, and it's in there. McRae has got 4 this quarter.
The inbound play works to perfection. You got to love to get those quick hitters.
It's Dragic with the drive, and that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
That's his first
of the day, Chris. I heard Commissioner Adam Silver talking about that it strikes him sometimes how isolated players can be with cell phones and headphones, and those things wouldn't help that. Is it something that you've noticed or that you're concerned about?
You mean with my nephews and nieces and friends that are younger and kids walking across
everybody.
The street looking at their phones and not even looking both ways?
You know, your play-by-play partner, whoever it might be.
Yeah. Oh, come on. You know, Kevin, those are the times. And so I would tell Adam Silver, Mr. Commissioner, yeah, that's a basketball problem. That's a world problem. How are we going to stop any of that? We're here now. There's no putting that genie back in the bottle. Okay.
And Goran Dragic drops them both.
And Dragic came into the NBA with something on his resume that not many other rookies have. He has a ring from winning the Slovenian Pro League the year before he came to America.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Shot by Crowder, no good.
The rotation in the D could be better here. It'll cost them next time if it's not.
Round kicks to Wood. There's the lob to the hoop.
And the pass there floated it up to the precise spot it needed to be.
And no messing around on the finish. He powers it through. Here's Iguodala, knocked away. And they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play.
Personal foul.
Well, all good things must come to an end. Iguodala was shipped out from the Warriors last year to clear room for D'Angelo Russell. Traded to the Grizzlies to make room for the Warriors in the Russell deal. Ultimately, I think we'll have a great legacy for his time with Golden State.
And the Pistons making a change here. Mekhi Lucas checked in. And that one falls for Iguodala. And with Andre Iguodala, he doesn't give you 20 points tonight like he once did, Greg, but he still shows up when you need him.
Iggy can still hit the switch, so to speak, and go back to his all-star level of play for stretches. I mean, the numbers don't jump out at you, but he is so valuable during big games, particularly in the postseason.
Just 4 to shoot. McRae passes to Wood, and Detroit again with the bucket.
How about this turnaround? He played a fringe role in the first half, and now he's the man for them.
Detroit's gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. And it's out of bounds. The Pistons able to retain possession here.
Looking here at some numbers for Brown.
A strong stretch of play the last 10 games. Averaging 9 points per game, 8 rebounds, and 4 assists. Yeah, he's been making the right decisions and letting the game come to him. Solid play all around.
Yeah, GA, I like it because he's not overcomplicating things. I mean, he's just playing to his strengths and taking what the defense gives him.
Got a piece of it. 2-on-1 as they jump out on the break. Here's Olynyk, drilled from 11 feet out.
Big basket.
Olynyk got his second bucket.
When Olynyk gets the ball in the mid-range area of the floor, he has no problem in letting it fly. I mean, he makes that shot consistently when he has the room to let it fly.
Now, here's Dumboya. Looking at his numbers, he's averaging about 6.5 points a game.
Oh, that's just a terrific night for him from the floor, making almost everything he looks at.
Here's Dragic. In it goes for the 8th time and 10 tries. Here's Galloway. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. A floater. It's hauled in by the Heat. Here's Iguodala. And that one hits back iron. Pistons shooting has been just great so far, up at 56%. Here's Mekhi Luke, and he takes that one up and powers it through.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
Oh, and with the fast eyes, Iguodala finding the open man.
Here's Galloway after the made shot from Goran Dragic. No good with the triple. Here's Iguodala. It's hauled in by Wood. Wood's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Out left to the wing, Galloway. Good on the triple. Galloway has got his first 3 points of the game.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and they aren't just chucking up anything. I mean, they're doing a great job of creating quality looks.
And, well, Detroit shooting it beautiful here in the third, 56% from the field.
2 minutes.
Here's Mekhi Luke. He's covered by Iguodala. Dumboya shakes off the strong D and gets to the bucket for 2.
and not relying at all on the three-point shot. They may want to rethink about stretching the defense a bit like they did in that first half.
Oh, and for Olynyk, not a big leaper, but he covers ground very fluid for a seven-footer.
A minute 42 left in the third. Here's Galloway. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. And it's Dragic with the rebound.
Still plenty of time for him to contribute in this game, but it's a tough stretch he's going through.
And that one, good. He's got eight.
Just giving up way too many transition opportunities.
One item that stood out, their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it makes it really hard to defend.
Here's Galloway. Six on the shot clock. And another three for Detroit.
Galloway, a dependable shooter from outside the arc. You can tell Galloway really believes in his three ball.
Unloads. Detroit with the rebound. And here is Dumboya. Down low. And a strong finish with two hands.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question. Silva, it's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Miami will retain possession. For the Pistons, Henson checked in for Christian Wood. Luke Kennard comes in for Thon Maker. And it's Rose in for Langston Galloway. Here's none, and that's a foul called on Bam Adebayo. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul, second team foul.
Here's Dumboya. 6 second difference between shot and game clock. Rose gets a wide open look, and there's another one for the Pistons.
And Rose always looking for his offense, and why not? He can put up points in a hurry.
Shots good by Hero. Hero's got 5 points now this quarter.
Hero!
15 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Now here's Rose. He's tightly guarded. Mikhailuk, and he makes no mistake on the slam dunk.
Assist. And you love to see Rose operating as a playmaker first and foremost.
Here's Nunn. Here's Jones. Off on that one. And so it's the Miami Heat rolling along with a 27-point lead as we wrap up the quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We'll get right back to the action when we return. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
How about the unselfishness? Night in and night out, we see guys trying to force their own agenda. Not that time.
And there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Adebayo is out there with Jones. Then there's Solomon Hill. Then there's Jimmy Butler. And it's Nunn in at the point guard. That's the group on the floor for Miami.
And that's why you never stop working in the paint at either end of the floor.
To the paint, here's Kennard. That's good. The assist that time from Knight. Kennard's got 19 points.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
Nunn can't get it to fall. The Pistons shooting 59% up to this point. They're working for great shots, and they're hitting them. Yep, it counts.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
Miami's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. The shot comes out. The Pistons go the other way with it. Passes to Knight. laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
And Sekou Doumbouya is going to pick up a foul. That is his first foul of the game.
Personal foul.
A negotiating concession the league wants from the players' union. Prospect attendance, Chris, at the draft combine and team-wide access to player physicals.
Well, this is a tough one because I don't think that a team that is not interested in you should have your physical. And we all know that information is shared, and so it should be genuine in the teams that are truly interested. So I understand agents holding back on that. Medical information is something very serious that just because you have an opportunity to be drafted, your information shouldn't be spread all across the world just because you're at a combine. It'll be interesting to see how it plays out, but basically you just want a level playing field for everyone. And if we have that, it'll be better for everyone.
Ooh, and that's right in the face of the D.
You know, he dealt with the pressure like it was nothing.
And he just punishes the D for falling asleep at the wheel.
Yeah, a little disorganized that time, and the result, 2 points in the loudest way possible.
No, well, listen, guys, that was great work, making them pay for the lapse on defense.
So it's Detroit now, the Heat getting the bucket. Here's Rose, and Detroit again with the bucket.
And such a tough cover off the dribble is Derrick Rose. When he stops short for the pull-up, you're really at his mercy.
And he gets the bucket.
Oh, the timing couldn't have been better on that assist.
The Pistons have gotten absolutely red hot shooting the ball here in the fourth. A perfect 6-for-6. Pistons passing it around. Kennard's shot is off. And it's Jones with the ball for the Heat. Butler goes in. And that comes off the assist by Jones. Jones has got 3 assists now in this one.
Contact doesn't get to Butler often. I mean, he uses his strength to his advantage in these situations.
And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Woods got 6 points in the quarter.
And I like that they're not settling. Getting the ball on the interior, 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Some say the mid-range jumper is dying out. Yeah, right. Guys like Butler, they're keeping it alive.
Here's Rose. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. Outside Griffin. And that one is stuffed right through.
You got to do more than that to keep the ball out of his hands down low.
Oh, they must ramp up the effort level, the intensity level. They're making it too easy for him out there.
Adebayo with the bucket.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Yeah, and it's inexcusable, but all too common. Basketball one-on-one. The shot goes up, put a body on someone.
Now a timeout called by Detroit.
And guys, one thing that has been interesting to see since Blake Griffin came to Detroit is how he's developed as a leader, has come into his own with how he takes responsibility for the team's play.
Leonard, he's checked in for Derrick Jones. And Jay Crowder's subbed in for Jimmy Butler. Jordan McRae, he's checked in for the Pistons. Bruce Brown comes in for Luke Kennard. Now here's Griffin. Shoots over Leonard.
Amazing awareness. He's committed to keeping his eyes up and teammates involved. That's the type of player Griffin is.
He'd have gotten exactly 2/3 of their shots to find the bottom of the net here in the fourth. 8 of 12. None. That's good.
None.
And with Griffin, you look at his time on the Clippers, and for most of his career, he was more of a second in command.
Coach Casey said last year early on that Griffin is the leader of this team, and Blake took it upon himself to step up to the challenge. Makes sense no matter how you look at it. He's their best player and needs to be one of the leaders.
None. That's good.
It's been a clinical performance. He's played a huge role and has them in position to grab the W.
From deep, Rose. Robinson pulls it in.
And it's only a matter of time until his three-point shot comes back to him. I mean, he knocked down two threes before halftime. Nothing so far here in the second.
And he sinks that one, hitting the back of the rim on the way in.
And now you can see the D having problems stopping the mid-range jumper, just not really closing out as much as they need to.
That's just the product of good pass work. I mean, nice team basketball right there.
Now a timeout called by Miami. Hey, Chris, for some guys, playing in their hometown is a dream. But there's also that added pressure, isn't there?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, at least when you play away from home, it's a little more quiet. You don't have to get as many tickets for the game. When I got a chance to play home in Detroit, it was one of the best moments of my life. And I thought to myself, this is a wonderful feeling, but could I have handled it for 15 years of my career? I don't know. That's 30 tickets a game. I probably would have to go back into the NBA again just to pay for those tickets, but I tell you what, it's fun. And for me, a mama's boy, eating your mama's cooking before a game, it is never, ever. I've never had a better feeling before a game than eating her food and being able to go out and play.
I bet.
Brand new everything. Yeah.
Miami's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Goes up on the wing. Here's Leonard trying to get open his Adebayo. And Leonard gets it to go.
Really nice job to convert the putback opportunity there. I mean, he stayed with that play from start to finish. That's something we say about him a lot.
Here's McCray. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
They are just killing him on the interior.
And so it's Crowder with it. He'll bring it up for the Miami Heat. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's going to be on Blake Griffin.
Myers.
Now with his face-up game, Myers Leonard comfortable playing at tower forward or center.
Yeah, Kevin, but if you look at the muscle he's added, he sure looks like a pivot. I mean, 7'1", solid, 260. The hammer. Well, that's at least what he calls himself. He's ready to bang.
And the first one at the line is good. And the former number 11 pick in 2012, it's taken some time for Myers Leonard. But you know what, Chris? The last couple of seasons, his offensive game really is rounding into form.
Yeah, and I wonder, because he's a great shooter and a quick-twitch athlete that can get his head at the rim, with a strong season at the line, could he be inducted into the 50-40-90 club?
Chris, there is that transition from being a player to retirement. It can be a challenge for some. What were the keys that you found in succeeding at that?
Well, first, I think it's adjusting to the fact you don't have the same schedule. You don't have a physical release that you used to have. You miss the locker room and the camaraderie with all the guys. And so you miss the culture. But secondly, I would say take all the lessons that you learned, and for me this was big, from sports, and use them in business. So in business, I became a rookie in other areas. I found a Chris Mullin type in business. I found a Latrell Sprewell type, guys that would mentor you, guys that you would play on their team. Humble yourself, get back to it, get to practice, get to meetings early, stay at practice late, stay at meetings, and be the last one that leaves. And just take the culture of basketball, infuse that athletic personality into the personality of whatever you go into next, and you can use those tenets to have a wonderful retirement and really enjoy it. So for me, it's been awesome. And by the way, I've had twins, and so since retiring, and that'll keep you just as busy as it was you were playing. So you can find ways to keep that same lifestyle.
That's right, and some sound advice too. Langston Galloway's checked in for Derrick Rose. Langston Galloway. Miami's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Here's Nunn. Here's Adebayo. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. Adebayo's got 12 points here in the second half. Brown outside. Inside. Here's Maker. The shot's good. Brown making the play.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Here's Nunn. And he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron. And, well, Detroit shooting extremely well. 62% on the night to this point. McRae passes to Maker. Here's McRae. Shoots from 12. He's 4-for-6 from the field with that miss. And Miami shooting has been just uncontainable, 72%.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And no good that time. Some solid defense from Robinson. Here's Nunn. A good finish at the rack off the slick feed. Nunn's got 40 points.
He's kept the integrity of their offense tonight by moving and cutting and scoring every time they've needed him to.
Galloway, the pass to Griffin. That one goes in.
Blake Griffin. Look out, everybody. Blake Griffin is having one of those nights. And when he's in this kind of mood, he is frightening.
Shot by Crowder, no good. Pass to Brown. The feed to Galloway. Fouled in the act of shooting. Gets the bucket anyway, so a three-point play chance for him.
And it's coming easy for them right now. Five baskets in a row in the paint.
And, Chris, one thing you have to like about Galloway is that he's always prepared to play.
Yeah, Galloway is the type of player that can see 5 minutes on the floor in one game and then start and play 25 minutes the next one. I mean, just think about that focus for consistency. The production can be hit or miss, but he's a great plug-and-play option for a coach in need of filling minutes.
That free throw good from Galloway. C-Web, the NBA always trying to improve every aspect of the game, and that includes officiating.
Yeah, and it should include officiating, one of the most important parts of the game and one of the toughest jobs within the business of basketball. I mean, these guys are calling, making calls on the fly without the advantage of the camera at home that we have watching through the screen, or without the advantage of slow motion technology. So first of all, kudos to the refs that go out and give it their best every day. We have the best refs in any of sports, I believe. And we still need to improve on that. The league recognizes that, and I love the fact that everybody's doing it together.
Here's Brown after the Heat pick up two. Here's McRae. Here's Maker. Great D that time from Leonard. Miami's gone 3-6 tonight when they've let it fly from downtown. Shoots from the baseline. Again, the Heat good for two.
Hero!
Here's Galloway. The pass to Brown. Six to shoot. Pass to McRae. Over Hill. And it's out of bounds, and they say it was last touched by Leonard. Olenek, he's checked in for Leonard. And Detroit with a change here, too. Knight's checked in. Dumboya kicks to McRae. We see the shift toward players on competing teams becoming friends. How does that compare to when you played, Chris?
It's a little bit different. The players that I admired the most, I wouldn't be friendly with on purpose. We were in the same position. A guy like KG, one of my favorite players ever. We're close now.
But during when we played, it was either me or him.
Really?
It was both of us. I didn't want to hang around with him when I'm trying to beat him in the summer. But, you know, you got guys like the Banana Boat crew and LeBron and Wade, they're good friends anyway. Melo and LeBron came in 1 and 2 and they had that relationship. So I think relationships are always great. Really, it's just about can you turn the friendship off when you cross the line? I know that Banana Boat crew can, and I know others can as well. And that's all you want. As much as you're friends off the court, I want you to dislike each other on the court through your friendship, just like a big brother, little brother type of thing. So I don't think it's a problem.
Free throw drops for Hill.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
Both free throws good from Hill. And here's Knight. He'll bring it up for Detroit. Passes it to McCray. Feeds it to Dumboya. And he uses the glass on the layup.
Look, that's a nice play. You need low post scoring to keep your offense balanced.
Here's Olynyk, and they cash in right away with the quick shot.
Such a dangerous scorer. I mean, Olynyk with the offensive skill set that you rarely see in a player his size.
And the dunk by Maker.
Oh, fellas, that was vicious. Two-hand monster slam.
Guys, I don't think there was anyone who could have stopped him on that one.
Hey, basketball.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
Yeah. Horrible effort. It appears they may be on the brink of giving up.
Here's Galloway. Pass to McCray. To the inside, Maker. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Maker's got 8 points here in this quarter.
There aren't many players as big as Maker. He realizes this. Nice work inside.
And another basket for Miami.
Heroes!
Detroit's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Knight passes to Maker. Here's Galloway. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Galloway has got 11 in the second half.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for Miami.
And this was one that never really was in doubt, I thought. An all-around dominant performance. And you kind of thought that maybe even going into the game.
Yeah, there was a sense of that in men. They just pretty much blew them right out of the water. A clinic was put on display here today.
And so they'll be advancing their win total to 42 games.
And continued dominance against this team, winning both of their matchups this season.
Oh, it's all about the assist on that play. He puts it in the perfect spot.
Got that one up quick.
Saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Oh, Greg, that's the dagger. You can tell they wanted that one. I know that seals the deal.
Now, here's Maker. McCray passes to Dumboya, and the layup's good off the glass.
And you can appreciate the fight now, but it isn't how they came into the game.
Yeah, how they ended this one is much different than how they started it. And that's a shame.
And the Heat call time here.
Heat dancers, let them hear ya!
We'll be right back.
with this game closing in on the final buzzer, let's take a look at our Jordan player of the game.
And what an amazing ball game we've seen from him. It's been a one-man show worth the price of admission all by itself. There wasn't anything he couldn't do on that court tonight.
They increased his role tonight after dropping their last game, and the move paid off. He's been the best player on the court by far, and now they don't have to worry about a losing streak. Oh. 40 seconds left in the fourth. Here's Nunn, and it's off the back rim, no good. Brown outside. In the corner, it's Galloway. The Pistons working the ball around now. The shot by Knight, no good. Guys, they can just sit on the ball here if they want to.
They have earned this win.
None, that's good.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
You know they are, sure. I mean, come on, the finish line is in sight. All they have to do is play it smart.
And so Miami takes this one by a big margin. They poured it on tonight. Dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do when they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Jimmy, you have been outspoken about the need for maximum effort. Was it part of your plan to grab wins like the one we saw tonight?
It wasn't a part of my plan, but whatever works, works. I think we got a bunch of talented guys, and at times we forget how hard we got to play. On the road, at home, this is how we got to play basketball.
Jimmy, thanks for the time, man. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.